Good morning, and welcome to the Student of the Month breakfast ceremony. My name is Toriano Griggs, and I'm the assistant principal for the class of 2019. It's my pleasure to be hosting this event, and it's an honor for these students to be recognized, considering the large population here at LT. The students being recognized today will be presented by their nominating teachers, and the teachers will share why their students have been nominated. However, because of their teaching schedules, some teachers may need to leave after their presentations, so please forgive any comings and goings. So let's begin. The first to present will be Greg Gutterson, presenting Miranda Vickery.
Good morning. Miranda is a sophomore in my keyboarding class, seventh hour. She's a part of the badminton and cross country team, as well as student council and spring snowball. Throughout the semester, Miranda has been a student that has worked hard and enhanced her keying skills. Through buying into the home row technique process, Miranda has increased her speed and accuracy immensely over the course of the semester. She challenges herself on a daily basis to improve her speed, accuracy, efficiency, and technique so that she will be prepared for the real world and those long papers in English class in college. And I actually just learned that she'll be studying abroad next year in France. So she's got a lot to look forward to. More importantly, I chose Miranda because she's a great person who helps out with her peers when they have questions. I have witnessed this firsthand as Miranda has gone out of her way with helping a special education student that sits right next to her to make sure he is always included and on task. Every day, this young lady asks how he's doing. She wishes him goodbye. And on the weekend, she says, have a great weekend. And then to me, having a daughter, I hope that she grows up to be just like Miranda, and I told Mom that earlier. She's developed a great rapport with the student and truly shows how wonderful a person she is. A true leader and a great person, I'm glad that I get to work with this young lady on a daily basis. She truly deserves this award, and I'm glad I was lucky enough to be her teacher. Thank you.
Our next presenter will be Lynn Meister, and she'll be presenting Madeline Walsh.
Good morning. I chose Maddie to be Student of the Month this year for Italian for a couple reasons. Number one, she's a great student. She's super bright, and she often goes above and beyond the work that is required of her in class and at home. And number two, not only is she one of the sweetest kids I've ever had the pleasure of teaching, but she's also one of the kindest people I think I've ever met. She not only shows that kindness to her family and her friends, but also to her classmates and even her teachers. So congratulations, Maddie. You are an awesome student and you are a wonderful, wonderful person. Congratulations.
Zainab Salah, presenting Grace Credit.
Good morning. Can you guys hear me? Okay. Grace has demonstrated strong self-advocacy skills in my class. Grace was at the boys' swim meet at LT, and she had taken a step and slipped. I believe she was there timing the swim meet, and after she slipped, it turned out that Grace had broken her hip and had to have emergency surgery. Two screws were placed in her right hip, and she was wheelchair bound for part of the semester. Despite these odds, Grace consistently advocated for herself. She always asked for work that she missed, she expressed when an extension was needed, and she demonstrated the ability to adjust to new situations upon returning to class. Grace is a wonderful student with an optimistic attitude and an infectious smile. She has taught me that despite the odds and no matter how difficult things may seem, there's always a possible positive outcome.
Missy Mitadero, presenting Liliana Smith.
Thank you. Lily couldn't be here today. She's out of town with her family. But it is my pleasure to award Lily Smith for the Physical Welfare Student of the Month. Lily is truly a pleasure to have in class and a great representation of the Physical Welfare Department. She is not only a great classmate and a student, but also a helpful friend to students in need. Within my class, a student who succeeds embodies respect, responsibility, attitude, and being a good person. Lily is diligent, hardworking, and demonstrates consistency in her effort in all that she does. She has a selfless attitude in that she befriends students who are in need of being included and supported. She is the first student to lend a hand to others and myself when in need. With these qualities, she will also be an outstanding student trainer for our athletics program this spring. It is my pleasure to award Lily Smith for Physical Welfare Student of the Month.
You don't want a photo by yourself over here? Chris Schroeder, presenting Gabrielle Monte.
Hello. Gabby has been one of the most passionate and courageous students that I have ever seen in my young years of teaching. She has been willing to be the model of openness, of empathy, and of courage in my class. Her volunteering, willingness to help others, and her constant enthusiasm about her work set the tone for what I expect out of all of my students. For making the class cry tears of joy, including myself, and bringing a dog in as part of a presentation to make a truly memorable learning experience.
Good morning. My name is Gary Monte. For my service project, I selected the Lutheran Church Charities Comfort Dogs. The Comfort Dogs were mainly used to help with disaster response. They gained notoriety in 2007 when a shooting occurred at Northern Illinois University. They were the only faith-based service allowed into the dorm rooms. The students loved them so much that several months later, they allowed them back to come back to the campus. The Comfort Dogs were featured on National Geographic's and Good Morning America. The Lutheran Charities Comfort Dogs' main purpose is to bring comfort and happiness to others, whether it be students studying for finals, older folks about to have surgery, or people suffering from devastating events, or a child just petting a dog. They also spread awareness to younger children about how to pet a dog and how to be courteous around the person who's walking the dog. My personal story with the Comfort Dogs is when I met a dog named Pax. When I was younger, I was almost bitten by a dog. I felt like I was living this fear for a very long time. Then I met Pax one Sunday through the LLC. He just curled up to me with a big, huge smile on his face. How could I say no to that? Thanks to him, I'm more comfortable around dogs, whether they be energetic or lazy. There are several scientific reasons why the therapy dogs are beneficial. Many hormones are released, like dopamine and oxytocin, when you pet them. They decrease cortisol, which is a stress hormone, and they're also really good with empathy. These are only a few of the many reasons why you should support these amazing dogs. These dogs share a passion to seek and comfort and let a person know that they are not alone during difficult times. And now it's my pleasure to introduce Mr. Mark Stapleton and Angel.
Come on. So Gabby, why don't you introduce your guest and let your guest tell us about his work and what he does.
This is Mr. Mark Stapleton from St. John's Lutheran Church and the comfort dog Angel. He's a golden retriever.
So this is Mr. Stapleton. He's going to introduce himself, tell him about what he does, and a little bit about Angel's history getting here.
Angel is a two-year-old golden retriever, and most goldens, as you might know, are either orange or red, and she obviously is not, okay? She's an English cream, but she's about as white as you can get, and that's why they called her Angel. She had nine brothers and sisters, and they all turned to kind of a cream color, all except for her. She stayed white, and they don't really know why, but that's very, very rare. So we go to different schools, we go to different deployments that Gabby talked about, but she's trained to be a comfort dog. She understands if you were having a bad day or really depressed, something like that, she gets that. And whoever trained her, and it wasn't me, I'm just the owner, okay? Whoever trained her did a really, really good job. So I think the best way of telling this is just to tell you a very, very short story. A few months ago, we were at an elementary school, and we were doing a presentation like this to the third graders, and everyone just sit down. And I put Angel down, and I'm talking to the classroom, and all of a sudden, Angel wanders off, and she did a visit on this little third grade girl's knee. Angel visit. That's a visit. And it's very touching, very tender. She just leaves her snout there. But she's not supposed to do that if I don't tell her. And so I bring her over, and I said, Angel, no, you stay. And I put her down. And a few minutes later, there she is doing a visit on the same girl's knee, and I couldn't figure out why. And I bring her over, and now I'm dragging her away from this little third grade girl. And I said, you stay. And she did stay then, but she kept staring at this little third grade girl the entire time. And I finally get through my presentation, teacher comes over, thank you for being here. That's really remarkable what you did, or what your dog did with a little third grade girl. And I said, I'm really sorry, she's not supposed to do that on her own, I'm very sorry. And teacher goes, no, I don't think you understand. That girl's family just put their dog down last night. And she's very, very depressed, and she's been crying this morning. And somehow Angel knew that. Or it was a big coincidence, but I don't think so. Like, that's the kind of things that this dog can do. And people that are very, very depressed, she understands that. Your body gives off a different smell when you are really down. You and I can't smell it, but the dog can. Their sense of smell is like 1,000 times better than you and I. So that's the kind of thing that this happens like once every month or two. It's just like, wow, I didn't see that coming, you know? And so. She's only 2 years old. She's still a pup, and she's still learning. But that's the kind of thing that we do.
We honor Gabby today.
Samson Guterman being presented by Annette Oracle.
There are certain students that stand out from the rest, not only because of their academic ability, but because of their personal qualities. Sam has impressed me as one of those students. Sam has a drive to learn and grow. You can find Sam asking questions, following up on concepts, and accepting and acting on feedback. He strives for understanding and for success. As a teacher, I am always trying to instill in my students a growth mindset, a mindset that recognizes that the most basic skills and abilities can be developed through dedication and hard work, a mindset that Sam has. I wanted to take this opportunity to let Sam know that his hard work, patience, and gracious demeanor have not gone unnoticed. Congratulations.
Thank you. Our next student is Peyton Johnson, being presented by Keith Bailey. Mr. Bailey could not be here today, so I will present on behalf of him to Peyton. So this is Mr. Bailey. I have been lucky to work with Peyton this school year in two environments at LT, the classroom with world history and the football field. Let's take tackle football first. Peyton may not be big in size, but his heart and determination were huge on the field. As a defensive linebacker, he was not afraid of hitting a running back at the line of scrimmage, which made a big impression on his teammates and me. In the classroom, Peyton would be his hardest critic and would say he could do better, and I know his work ethic is hard up to meet the challenge. He is a constant contributor to class discussion and works well with his classmates in group activities. It's been a pleasure to see his growth this school year. Congratulations for being my student of the month. Stacy Ambrosic will present Justin Ibarra.
Good morning. It's my pleasure to award Justin with Student of the Month for math this month. Justin is a great all-around math student. He's always willing to answer questions in algebra with well-thought-out responses. During group and pairs activities, he's always willing to work with any student and is actively engaged during the lessons. It's certainly a pleasure to have Justin in class because he kind of adds a little lively spirit to our class. So I'd like to congratulate Justin for the Math Student of the Month.
Our final presentation will be made by Jane Bauer, and her student is Nicole Sisson, who is not here yet. But come on up, Ms. Bauer.
So I know Nicole was hoping to be here, but she had to take a bus, and so I warned her about today because I wish you could have met her. She's got quite a spunk. She was nominated because between freshman and sophomore year, there's huge growth, and kids definitely mature and they develop. And Nicole started high school with not necessarily the best appreciation for school and for LT. She came from a small school, and suddenly she felt like a small fish in a big pond. She didn't think the teachers cared about her. She didn't feel like she connected with the students. And it was a little bit of a rough year, and we worked a lot together. And then suddenly this year, I realized I hadn't been seeing Nicole much. And then suddenly I realized I would see her, and she looked different. And she's talking to the students, and she realized that her teachers were on her side, and she realized school was actually a fun place to be. And with the improved attendance, suddenly we were talking about honor roll and discounts on driver's insurance, and it's amazing how those kind of things come up in sophomore year. And she looked differently, and she had such a difference about her this year that I wish you could see her, because she's just this perkier young lady talking about healthcare careers and, again, driver's insurance, and her improvement has been so remarkable that the teachers and peers and everyone were really grateful that she's had such a great sophomore year, and we look forward to next year at North Campus. So, and that's Nicole.
This concludes our Student of the Month ceremony, but before we leave, I'd like to thank the following people. LTTV and Mrs. Faye for filming. I'd like to thank Bree Torres for putting this all together. I'd also like to thank Mr. Randy Antlip for taking photos for us. I'd like to thank our award winners. Congratulations. You set yourself apart from other students with your hard work, commitment, integrity, thoughtfulness, academic success, leadership, and positive attitude. But last but not least, I'd like to thank and congratulate the parents. Without your support, commitment, guidance, we wouldn't have such fine, wonderful people to be congratulating today. So thank you. And for the students, we're going to take one group shot right over here, and then you can go off to class. Thank you again.